Welcome to chapter 12.7. This section is about triple integrals in cylindrical and spherical coordinate system. So now we have two new coordinate systems that we are going to use to solve triple integrals. The first one is cylindrical coordinates. Basically, cylindrical coordinate system is an extension of the polar coordinates into three-dimensional space. Now, when do we use these cylindrical coordinates? Well, if you have a cylindrical surface and a surface of revolution, then it is easy to use cylindrical coordinates to represent the corresponding surface. Let's consider a point in R3. Let's say we have a point in R3. And this point has a coordinate x, y, z with respect to the Cartesian coordinate system. Now, the same point can be expressed using the cylindrical coordinates. Now, the cylindrical coordinates are we have three coordinates, r value, theta value and the c value. So in Cartesian coordinate system we have x, y and c, but in cylindrical coordinate system we have r, theta and c. Okay. Now let's consider the point x, y, c. Now if you project this point onto the xy plane, or if you mark the xy coordinate, let's say this is your xy coordinate, that's the x value, and this is the y value. Okay. Now, the distance between the origin, let me use a different color. The distance between the origin and this point is r. And the angle between the positive x-axis and this blue line is theta. And this height is c. So this is the way we represent a point in R3 using the cylindrical coordinate system. We have three parameters, r, theta and c. R is the radial distance from the origin. Theta is the angle between the positive x-axis and this blue line. And c is the height. Okay. The conversion formulas. We know that x equals to r cosine theta, y equals to r sine theta. Again, these two are very similar to the polar coordinate system. And now we have c equals to the same c coordinate. Because of this, we have x squared plus y squared equals to r squared. Tan theta equals to y over x and c coordinate equals to c. Okay. Next, we are going to consider an example. Let's say we want to find an equation in cylindrical coordinates for a cylinder that has the equation x squared plus y squared equals to 16. So now, with respect to the Cartesian coordinates, equation of this cylinder is x squared plus y squared equals to 16. But now our goal is to find the equation of this cylinder with respect to the cylindrical coordinates. Okay, now we know that in cylindrical coordinates, x squared plus y squared equals to the variable r squared. So we have r squared equals to 16, and therefore r equals to 4. So this is the equation of a cylinder in cylindrical coordinate system, and the radius of this cylinder is 4. Let's try another one. Let's say we want to express this paraboloid in cylindrical coordinate system. So we use the same trick. We want to group x squared plus y squared terms, so let's factor out 5. Now we have 5 times y squared plus x squared, but x squared plus y squared equals to r squared. So in cylindrical coordinate system, equation of the given paraboloid is c equals to 5 r squared. Equation of this cone. Now c equals to square root of x squared plus y squared. This means c equals to square root of r squared, and it's nothing but r. Now as you can see, in cylindrical coordinate system we have very simple equations for these surfaces. Last one. We have a sphere with radius 4 and we want its cylindrical representation. Well, x squared plus y squared is r squared, so we have r squared plus c squared equals to 16. That's it. This is the equation of the sphere with radius. Next, we are going to start triple integrals in cylindrical coordinate system.